your largest fan sites on social media. And she's saying that she's getting so many questions that she can't pick just one. So she wants to know, do you have a message to your Turkish fans?
Well, my message to them is, I have a message for them and I have a question for them. How did they start watching my films is my question. Where did it begin? I have no idea. And because it's a different language and you know, it's, so that's a question which I would like you to answer for me. But my message to them is that I don't know how it started, but I'm really happy it did. And I'm really grateful for the love and, that I get from my audience here in Turkey. And I'm really happy to be here finally.
Mesajla beraber bir sorum da olacak. Sorum öncelikle şu, filmlerini nasıl izlemeye başladınız? Yani farklı bir dil. Ama bu önemli değil, nasıl başladığınızı bilmiyorum ama başladığınız için çok mutluyum. Sonunda Türkiye'de olabilmekten çok memnunum. Ve hayranlarıma teşekkür ediyorum.
Cheeky second question, thank you. Obviously, people who will watch the film, those audience members, if they perhaps share the same value as Insiya's father in the film, you know, they are perhaps conservative or perhaps have been known to oppress their women a little bit and their daughters, do you think they're going to be receptive to the narrative of this film? And more widely, do you believe your films do change people's lives and those narratives?
Well, I think it's a very important question. I think that when we are making films or telling stories or communicating with audiences across the world, there are times when we are also speaking to people who completely disagree with what we're saying. Certainly there are times when we communicate with people who are opposing to the idea that you're trying to communicate. And I respect that. I think that there is, you know, every point of view is important. And I feel that when you are trying to communicate to a person who thinks completely contrary to what you're thinking, it's important to do that communication with love. It's important to reach out with love. It is important to include that person in the conversation as opposed to exclude the person. You know, when you're saying, you know, I don't want to include you in this conversation. But that's not what I believe. I'm happy to hear opposing opinions, and I'm happy to include people with diverse opinions and opinions, and I want to communicate with them as well. Yeah.
Film yaparken ve hikayeler aktarırken karşıt düşüncelerde olan izleyicilerle ilgili bir soru sormuştunuz. Ve tabii ki de filmlerimizde bu karşıt düşüncedeki insanlara ulaşıyoruz. Buna saygı duyuyorum. Tam tersini düşünen biriyle iletişime geçince bunu önemli olan şey sevgiyle yapabilmek ve karşı çıkmaktansa karşınızdaki insanı dinlemek, aktif olarak onlarla konuşmaktır. O yüzden farklı görüşteki insanlar filmlerimi izlediği için değil mi?
I'm more interested about your activism work.
No Hindi this time, don't worry. I'm more interested in your activism work. For instance, you started Pani Foundation after Satya Mirjati, and one of the episodes in Satya Mirjati was mental health, and it's a very dear episode to my heart. Are you planning on taking another course of action about mental health, you know, like you did in Pani Foundation, maybe in your foundation?
Well, you know, this journey of Satyamev Jayate was very, very important to me and very enriching to me. It was a huge, huge learning experience. I got to understand so many things about my country, about my culture, and I felt I got closer to the people. It was a very traumatic experience because as you learn more, you also see a lot of things which are very unpleasant. So it was a very traumatic experience, but at the same time it was very, very inspiring because you also get to meet people who are so courageous and so, you know, such good people. And they give you hope, they give you strength. There are people who have very political strength, power or money power or any, they're not very powerful people as we understand the word, but their inner strength is something that is so strong and really inspires us. So this entire journey was really amazing for me. Mental health is certainly something that we need to talk about more, especially in India. Very little is known about it, very little is understood about it. And so that the episode we did on mental health in Satyameva Jayate was an attempt to try and, was an attempt to just understand the very basics of it. I don't know whether I can take on mental health as an issue as we go ahead right away, because my entire team of Satyameva Jayate is currently working on Pani Foundation. So we have our hands full with that. It is an attempt to try and contribute to the solution to the drought that we have in Maharashtra, the state that I live in. Maharashtra, you have to remember, is bigger than Germany. That's how large the state is. And it also has a population, I think, if I'm not mistaken, which is bigger than Germany. So it is a huge, challenge that we've taken. And that is really occupying all my time and attention, and the time and attention of my entire team from Satyameva Jayate, which is fully working on Pani Foundation right now.
Şunu sordum. Satyameva Jayate'den sonra bir Pani Foundation kurdular. Eyaletlerindeki su kısıtlığını gidermek için çeşitli uygulamalar ve çözümler arıyorlar. Bu programın bir bölümünde de Foundation için programın bir bölümünde de akıl sağlığı, mental health konusunda program yapmışlardı. Sorun şuydu. Akıl sağlığına yönelik de bir çalışma yapmayı düşünüyor musunuz?
Bu akıl sağlığı üzerindeki yolculuk benim için çok önemliydi ve çok şey öğrendim. Ülkemle ilgili çok şey öğrendim. Bu zaman zaman travmatik olduğu kadar iyi de bir deneyimdi. Çünkü ya o kadar cesur ve iyi insanlarla tanıştım ki bu güçleri paraları değildi, bu güçleri içlerinden geliyordu. Akıl sağlığı çok konuşulan bir şey değil ülkemde. Çok şey bilinmiyordu. Televizyon programında bunların temelini anlamaya çalıştık. Şu an bahsettiğiniz kurumuyla da, bu eyalette su ile ilgili kurumuyla da bütün ekibi ilgilendiği için bu soruna bir çözüm bulmak için tekrar akıl sağlığı ile ilgili henüz şu an bir şey olmayacak.
Sorularımız bitti artık. Amerikan'a bu güzel işi ve sorularımıza verdiği cevaplar için çok teşekkür ediyoruz. Biz de film artı olarak 20 Ekim'de Hindistan'la aynı tarihte Secret Superstar filmini Türkiye'de gösterime sokmak için çok heyecanlıyız. İlk kez bir Amerikan filmi Hindistan'la aynı tarihte ülkemizde gösterime girecek. Hayranlarının, sevenlerinin, bütün sinema severlerinin bu filmi de çok seveceğine inanıyoruz. Yine tekrar Amerikan Productions'a, Amerikanlar burada bizimle olduğu için ve Z Studios'a çok teşekkür ediyoruz. Hepinizin de filmi keyifle seveceğine inanıyoruz. Katıldığınız için teşekkür ederiz.